far. They're under 500 and are three games back in the playoff race. This is all leading to speculation that Luke Walton could be out as head coach. But that's not going to happen, according to the LA Times. Reports say Jeannie Buss, Magic Johnson, and GM Rob Pelinka are all united in keeping Walton for the rest of the season. However, the report adds the execs see a, quote, disconnect between Walton and the players, and they feel LeBron isn't totally engaged. So we're joined once again by Celtics legend Brian Scalabrine. Corrected myself.
Yeah, you're right.
I'm going to ask you to be a little unbiased in this segment as we talk Lakers. But what do you think? Would it be a mistake to let go of Luke?
Yeah. I mean, he's built this culture so far. I know it's not what they expect, but LeBron missing 18 games, that's not an easy thing to do. And the Western Conference, don't look at the records. When you look at the players in the Western Conference, night in and night out, you're in for a dogfight. And that's just how it is for the Lakers. And that's why I kind of expected them to be on the outside looking in throughout this playoff. I did not expect Sacramento to be this good or the Clippers to be this good, but it's hard out West. It's not an easy thing to get over that hump.
But to you, I agree, obviously, with Brian. I think it would be a mistake to let Luke go. You brought up the 18 games LeBron's missed. If he doesn't miss those games, they're fighting. They're probably around fifth or sixth in the West. You know, and we're not talking about Luke. They may be talking about, can they win the West? You know, can they get to the conference finals with Luke? And maybe we should get rid of him because then maybe they would never be satisfied. But my point, there's other guys. You know how important Rondo can be to a team.
Sure.
He's missed 34 games. Brandon Ingram's missed 11. Lonzo Ball's missed 10. And when you have, they had about 10 or 11 guys that could arguably think, I should be playing. When you have that many guys that deserve to play and you have all these injuries, it's hard to get a set rotation. So I understand why Luke has had trouble getting the rotation set when guys have been in and out of the lineup. And I talked before, Brian, about the defense. The defense, I think that's a sign of a good team, a good coach, is when your team buckles down and plays defense. They're 12th in the league right now in defense. They were in the top 10 before Lonzo Ball got hurt, who for some reason is really important to their defense because he's long, he's rangy, he's got good instincts, and they like to switch everything so he can switch. So I'm just saying, not to mention the makeup of the roster, you put it together without three-point shooters, even though you brought in LeBron James. Then at the trade deadline, they go and get some
three-point shooters. How many excuses are you going to make?
No, these are facts.
Yeah, that was a lot.
There's a difference. There's a difference between
facts.
Because I'm dropping facts. There's a difference between facts and excuses. You make excuses.
I'm not making
excuses. I drop facts.
These are excuses.
Is it not a fact that LeBron was out and that he makes a difference?
Is this a results business? Nobody in their right mind thought they'd be on the outside looking.
He just said it.
Even you did. You didn't think they were going to make the playoffs this year with LeBron James.
I just think the West is the beast. I look at the Western Conference.
Here's the other thing. LeBron James, Chris Broussard, is back on the court. He's
not injured.
Rob,
don't be a prisoner of the moment.
Back. They lost to Atlanta the other night. LeBron had a triple-double, and they lost. They're on the outside.
So that's why Luke should get fired.
I'm telling you.
Because LeBron had a triple-double and they lost.
No, I'm just saying because they lost also to the Cavaliers and the Knicks at home.
Sure.
The Lakers.
Without LeBron.
You can't just pick games out.
I'm picking those games.
You can't do that. In 82 games, you can't do that.
Because they beat OKC. They beat Golden State.
But here's the other thing.
They're better than those teams.
Luke wasn't hired by Magic or Pelinka. He's not their guy.
Yeah, but that's not what she's asking. That's not what she's saying. Should he be fired? Not, is he going to?
If they continue this downward slide as we move into the final 25 games, they might need to do something to try to shake it up and save this season.
Wait, how are you going to save this season?
Easy to make the playoffs. Everybody would still rather LeBron James make the playoffs and have a chance than him being on the outside looking in and not making the playoffs at all.
I'm with Rob, and here's why. It's a mistake in some. And, Brian, you know this. When you're in a locker room and there is conflict and there's tension, meaning you got Rondo, you got JaVale McGee, you got Lance Stephenson, all these three veteran guys on a one-year deal, they're trying to play and get an extension somewhere, and if not with the Lakers. Then you have these three young guys who are trying to play themselves into a contract and get long-term deals, and there's tension because we were out the window just a week and a half or so ago because you were trying to acquire Anthony Davis. Now all of a sudden we're here. This is what Luke Walton has to deal with, and he hasn't been able to corral these guys. You don't have the ear of your superstar in LeBron James. And so when if I'm a young guy and I'm all these other veterans and I see the number one person on this team doesn't even listen, or you can't influence him, you can't get him to play hard or
play defense
or do the things that you need to do as a head coach to echo. You got to have that player that you know can speak to the team and have influence echoing what you're doing at that head coach position. And he doesn't. He doesn't have that. I'm not saying he's a bad coach. I'm not saying that Luke Walton can't get another job somewhere, and I'm sure he would. But right now, they have to shake something up because LeBron isn't sold on Luke Walton. And that's why you acquire LeBron James, and now all of a sudden, we're acting as though he wasn't going to have problems with what's in place.
Was LeBron sold from the get-go?
He was sold because of Magic. Mm.
But no, was he sold on Luke?
He didn't meet him for like 4 weeks after he signed.
Because maybe they should have made the coaching. You're right. I mean, obviously you need your superstar and the other players to buy in. But if they knew if LeBron wasn't sold in November or December, maybe that would have been the time. But here I go. Even if he wasn't sold in, they still were the fourth seed at one point.
Yeah, but that was so long ago. When you
that was like
the team,
a month and a half.
The question was, should he? That was the question. Not will he or LeBron. Should he? He should not be fired. I mean, he's done.
Why should he not be fired? Tell
me. He has exceeded expectations with LeBron out.
18 under 500?
Games? Yeah. LeBron missed 18 games.
Yeah, but some of those games.
Go look at all the games where LeBron is.
Go look at the schedule on some of the games that they lost when LeBron was out. They should have won those games. They weren't prepared.
But they also beat Oklahoma City in Oklahoma City.
Very nice.
Out.
And you
they
know what?
Weren't
you
just
the one that said lost 18 straight? The Knicks have lost 18 straight. Guess what game they won?
The Laker game.
In L.A.
That's the reason?
If you're going to discredit Luke and the Lakers.
Oh, no.
You just. If you're going to discredit and blame him for the bad losses, then you have to give him credit for the good wins.
See, this is
give him credit for Golden State.
This is what
give
I'm
him credit
doing.
For OKC, at OKC without LeBron.
I'm not blaming Luke. I'm just saying from
so the
a
answer
team,
is no.
So you're not saying he should.
No, he should not be fired.
From a team dynamic, when you're in a locker room and you don't have the ear of the players from a head coach perspective, the odds are you're going to move on with that guy because we need somebody that can corral these guys, that these guys are going to be willing to play for. It's not about how great a coach you are and how effective you've been with or without LeBron James. Where are they and what they've done? Two totally different things. I want them to be successful. I believe
that. You see it.
But I can. I'm a realist.
For him, he should be fired because LeBron and the players are basically tuned him out.
Yes.
That's what you're saying.
Yes.
Let's look at this from a different angle. So the LA Times report from Brad Turner says that Luke's job is safe through the end of the season. Okay, so there's that. Lakers are still trying to make the playoff. They're a couple games out. We'll have Brian chime in and try to help the Lakers make the playoffs. You've played with Rondo. Rondo's on that roster. What kind of leader is he? Maybe he's an X factor that can step up and corral this team and get them to refocus, maybe.
I just saw them come back from a big deficit in Boston on a big night, Thursday night, Patriots in the front row getting honored, all that stuff. And they came in and they chipped away. They looked like a well-coached team. Now you move on to the Atlanta game. You go to the Philadelphia game.
And in Indiana, when they gave up 140
points. Yeah, and they gave up the 42 points. So they're inconsistent, but that's expected with LeBron coming back. He will just go back. They had an all-time great team when he was in Miami. They lost 5 of 6 games during that stretch. So he has had those type of things. Now, with Rondo there, they can find a groove with all kinds of Lonzo Ball getting hurt, Ingram getting hurt. Once they find their groove, then I can see them winning 8 of 9. And now all of a sudden, 8 of 9 gets you into the playoffs. So that is, to me, for them, with LeBron missing all these games, that should be the standard. And going back to Rondo, I think he's a phenomenal leader. I know it's like he's very polarizing when you think about.
But when he gets in a situation where he fits well.
Yeah, he can lead teams. He can make players better. So you have young guys. You want to, the biggest thing you want to do this season for them is take your young guys and showcase them. LeBron makes people around him better. Rondo makes people around him better. If I have young players and I'm trying to showcase them, I want those two guys on my team. And I think Luke Walton also understands that. I don't know if he'll be back next year, if they got AD in the offseason. I don't know any of those things. But I'm looking at what they're doing right now. Luke Walton, Rondo, LeBron, they do have what it takes to flip the switch and get into the playoffs in the Western Conference. But they have to. They can't have those bad losses to Atlanta on the road.
The legend has spoken.
There we go.
Mic drop. The legend agree with me. I'll have you two know. I'm just saying.
Chris,
he did.
You believe everyone agrees with you.
It does. That's
the question was, should Luke, would it be a mistake to keep Luke the rest of the year? He said no.
I don't want to debate it
Greg
again.
And I said moving on.
Yes. Moving on.
Moving on.
Will the Sixers grab the throne in the East?